Okay. There we go. Sound okay? Hey, Scott. How you doing tonight? I am struggling. Oops. Well, what did I do? I am doing pretty good, except for something happened to my game sound now. Oh, I know what. Hold on a second. Oh, still didn't fix it. What is going on? There we go, there we go. Yeah, so I'm finding out that these silos apparently are all decorative. So that kind of sucks. So we'll get these guys harvesting, but set them on course play. And then I will jump over and I guess just have to place something. Door. How are you doing, Scott? Thanks again for stopping by. Let's see, where's the door? I think it's over here. My wife is out of town on the girls' trip weekend, so I'm gonna have a couple nights of good streaming I can do. Oh, nice. What map is he running? I don't remember. Downloaded the East River auto drive. Pardon me, auto drive that somebody had thrown out on FS19 all a bunch of different mod sites it's available on. And, man, let me tell you, like, bring the map, let's see if we can see it. Yeah, so this guy made points, multiple points, for every different, all the different fields. I don't remember if there's any, like, load unload points, but there's at least a start point for all the different. Valley the old farm. Nice. I was running a series on Old Farm Countryside. Need to get that going again. Every time I see that name, it reminds me. I need to do that. Let's see, where are we going? The wrong way for sure. This way. I have not played on Valley of the Old Farm, but I've watched a few series on it, and it looks like a really, really good one. Oh, you know what? Let me get rid of these things. Don't need these stupid header trailers. I struggled with those last time. Good riddance. Let me see. Get this out of the way a little bit. This Dura's 60-foot header should make quick work of this field. Especially if I get two of them going on it. Mm. Nice. Yeah, I'm starting to do that on my, get off there. My Eureka series, starting to just merge all the fields together. Oh, where is this field? There. Alright, let's see if I can do this. I'm trying to get better at course play. Hopefully you don't watch me struggle too hard. All right, field work, first generation. Headlands around, counterclockwise, two. Multiple tools, skip those. Yes. Yes, yes, thank you. Thank you. But please, point and laugh. I'll figure it out eventually. And no, I don't think anything is going to be quick. All right, let's see what happens. What is he going to do? Oh, wait. Lane offset, one right. Okay, yep, so then I'll do the other one, the one left. Drive course. first waypoint. Okay. Odd approach, but... And the next one. I already realized I messed up because I got his pipe on the wrong side. Whatever, we'll just... We're not realistic here. I also need to change this PLX because it does not want me to open the door on the trailer. It doesn't give me an option. And I had heard some people the other day talking about they got rid of the TLX trucks because of all the keybind issues, and I hadn't really had too many issues until now. See if I can get this. The heck just happened? Going on. Oh gosh, what the heck is going on? Uh-oh. What the heck is going on? What's going on with yeah, something is not right. Oh yeah, something is wrong here. Okay. Yep, I don't see any money. All right, let's do this. Bear with me a moment. I'm gonna give the server a quick whack. Well, it's not a Fusion stream unless something goes wrong, right? At least lately. Give me just a moment. Give this a quick restart here. All right. Let's give that a go. It even gave me an error restarting the server. I had to completely stop it and then start it again. Well, if this acts up again, I'll just jump out and go over to the Yukon server. Let's see what happens. Come on. Talks amongst yourselves. We'll be there in a sec. And there we go. Maybe. Maybe. Getting there. Okay. Let's try again. Okay. No weird spinny stuff going on here. Waypoint. Yeah. Don't need that. Okay. And then I need one left, I think. And first waypoint, go. Did I do this right? Odd approach, but looks like he's got it. Sweet. And let's check. How are we doing here? So he's getting close. Okay, we're just gonna sell this thing. I think I bought both, two of them, yep. Sell. Gun truck. Sure. Roadrunner. Yeah, sometimes I gotta have fun, right? Sure, doesn't matter. Trailer I forgot to bring over. Oh, I missed Riley. Field 57. Holy cow. Field 57 East. Good. Now, we can go and load. I'm imagining that's very loud. It's very loud for me. just cut through these trees here. That they do. Where is he? Yeah, this kind of map, unless you've got multiple people on. You've got to have automation. That's something to work for. You see us, I'm coming. Maybe I can convince Scorpion to join me tomorrow. This is not gonna make it. Hopefully that truck gets here. Where's he at? Almost here. I was actually thinking about switching out the fence, or switching out the deers for fence. There he goes. Come back. I messaged him, I DM'd him on Discord. I guess it was a couple days ago, yesterday maybe. And shot him the server info, but I haven't talked to him since then. I started a new job this week, so I've been kind of trying to lay low on the Discord and jumping in the middle of the day streams and stuff, so I kind of get settled in. But I think I'll definitely be able to a little bit more starting next week. Yeah, I, like I said, I messaged him and he responded, but I haven't, and he was on one of my streams the other day, but I've been following Discord enough to know his whereabouts otherwise. Okay, what is going on? Why? Oh, he's still driving, that's why. There we go. Okay. I was getting worried that it was not just the truck. Come over here a little bit. I forgot which side of the thing the pipe's on. Go chase these guys down and get them unloaded, and then I'll have to go figure out a silo situation. It's very odd because the map says there's a silo right there. And when you tag it, it points to the, you know, these guys. But I can't figure out what to do with them other than I can't get out of here now. And I did a cheat silo to put 1,000 liters of weed in just to see where it went, and I haven't the foggiest, so I'll just have to put something else down. Oh. Actually, I wonder if I can do this. Default. Build 57. East. Unload company. East. Go. Ah, okay. I wondered if the... Oops. The names were like, well, they're in German, silage something. That makes sense now. And I got junk littered everywhere. Oh, wrong side. Smart one. Get this stuff out of the way, and I think we can get into a rhythm. Yeah, I remember seeing those blue ones on. They put the Placeable USA pack, which is what those are from, on the UConn server, but I never. We never messed with them because I just took one, the silo, the big mega silo that it comes with. And modded it to hold like, I don't know, 9 million liters or something, and multi fruit. And then we put like some kind of silage cow feed mixer that could crank out a lot of silage. Where is it? Yes, I know. Yeah, nothing in global companies. The garage menu doesn't even show that we own it, which is odd, but it shows the silage clamps sitting next to it that we own. So I don't know. And then there's the grain bins that need the auger stuff, but they look like they're just decoration as well, because you can't interact with the augers either. Okay. Those are out of the way. And then now I'm going to move this truck out of the way and see what this guy wants to do. He's trying to go somewhere. Where is... Oh. Where is it? I can't tell. I was trying to see where the waypoint was. That's fine. Let's just get this guy over here. I made a right mess of this. Need to turn that course play thing off. Tab to, or click to tab. Okay, looks like he's doing something now. Maybe. Let's go see what he's doing here. Waiting for call. Alright. If it's anything like Yukon, it'll take him like 5 minutes to figure out what he's supposed to do. On that pistol. Hello. There we go. It shouldn't fill it. Well, maybe it is. Sure did. All right, let's go ahead and do that then. Yep, okay. Yeah, you're right. Yep. I didn't doubt you, but yeah, I see now. It only holds animal feed. Let's see, this one is not fully multi-fruit. Actually, maybe. Maybe it is. One thing I've noticed about these giant maps, if you hit shift, it gets stuck. The guy that did the Yukon server somehow figured out how to get it to stop doing that. I wish I knew what he did. I'd try to fix it on this one. I'll get there. Where is it? I was way over here. Okay. I'll be glad when they fix this in 22. So I need to go this way. Just have to be careful not to hit shift. Alright, this thing is huge. Where can it go? And give me turnaround space. Well, not the most elegant, but maybe right over here. Let's do this. Okay, I need to paint. Where's the It's not gonna get rid of the trees. Damn. Okay, we'll just put it there, I guess. Alright, now we're in business. And then, while we're at it, we'll make a auto dump point. All right, there we go. And then we'll make a route back. Clean that up later. Keyboard steering is not elegant. Hey, welcome, Daryl. Don't have any MPers on with me, unfortunately, at the moment, but still really just getting things set up, so it's a brilliant map. Let's see. And then I can just tie back in right here. That's fine. Thanks for stopping by, I appreciate it. And I guess while I'm at it, we'll get this all going and get to the back to the harvest in earnest. What happens? Well, actually, let me look and see where the... Oh, it's right there. Okay. D7 East. Yeah, that works. Okay, I don't know where he's gonna go, but he'll make it eventually. I don't know what this guy's doing. Hey, my pleasure. Yeah, it's a really great looking map. And somebody put together a auto drive out. So I was just adding on for our farm, but if you look here, all the little points here, somebody made, I think they said all the points. Yeah, it looks like some of the farm. This is like the starting farm. I bought down here. But yeah, all the fields all the sell points, and I think most of them are either they have most of them have 2 points, a north south or an east west. So like Field 57, there's an east and a west. It's on I think I got it from FS19.net, but I think I type in Peace River Auto Drive if you want it, and you should see it on any number of sites. So tell me, Daryl, do they run a lot of Fendt up there or John Deere's? I watch Mike Mitchell occasionally, and I know he's kind of up that way. And he seems like he's got kind of a good mix of both. Hey, RxZ. Good to see you, my friend. Things are slowly getting better. Trying to get some automation going. Deers and fence, yeah. Good, so I'm on the right track. Alright, let's see if I can get this guy to cooperate. I wonder if it's because I don't have this set. RxZ, you're probably much better versed at this than I am. Do I need to set the combine to this field as well on the auto drive? It seems like I tell the guy to unload the combine. I do the unload combine setting, and he just kind of sits there. But I'm also pulling from experience from Yukon, where it seemed like it would take ages for them to respond. So I want 57 East. And then I need this other thing here. My goal was to be the chaser. Okay. I just did, so we'll see that combine. We'll see if anything happens, and I'll do it for this other one when I find him. Nothing to see here. Let's see if he starts moving. Looks like he's still just sitting there, so. Hey, was that my sub tracker that just worked? Somebody just subbed? I can't see who it was. I do apologize, but I do appreciate it greatly. Thank you. I'm still figuring out this streaming thing, so if I miss something, I do apologize, or miss a comment, I'm sorry. Awesome. Well, good to know that at least my little setting worked, because all of a sudden I heard my little intro sound. And I thought I'd done something wrong, because I actually forgot it, that I had that turned on. All right, so these guys should be good. Let me set this guy to East 57. Okay. And now I actually need to go and get another truck. Let's grab this. Sure, John Deere. This guy back and on another trailer. Let's go ahead and do this. I don't feel much like driving at the moment. Off you go. So he's still sitting there. Waiting for call. Okay. Well, we'll just leave it be. Oops. Oops. I keep pushing the wrong button. This guy I want to do 57 East, and then I want to take it to where is it gonna go? There, wheat. So maybe that's a good sign. It just popped up saying he can't calculate. Like I said, I remember on it would do that over and over and over for like 5 minutes, and then finally it would start. And once it understood where it was supposed to go, it could run pretty smooth after that. That guy's still going. That's still going. Okay. This guy's ready to make a run. Very good. Wow. Is that like the straw pellets? Because I'm messing with that on Eureka, and it's, I tried doing the stationary build, and it's taken a long time. I'm kind of regretting that decision. Get this guy lined up. Pick up and deliver. Actually, while I'm thinking about it, I better move this. Yeah, you and me both, Daryl. I have to pull myself away. Sometimes it's my wife having to do it for me. What's over here? Yeah. I'm on my PlayStation in bed. We'll watch some TV, whatever, until she falls asleep, and then I'll pop on my PlayStation. And sometimes she'll wake up at 2:30 in the morning and I'm still playing. Go to bed. Just one more harvest. Let me finish feeding the animals. I'm in the middle of recording. I can't stop now. Yes. That's absolutely true, which is mostly why I wait until she falls asleep. Oops, wrong button. What is he doing now? Oh, he showed up. Okay, cool. Where's the other one? No. I've never seen that before. We're in the wrong field. Yeah, it is cool. Yellow, green's good, yellow's close, and then red is, I don't remember exactly when it turns red. I don't know if it's 100% or, you know, like 90-something percent. Yeah, really handy too if you like to night harvest. You can see it from, you know, halfway across the field. Let's do, well, I don't really know where he was. His texture is different. Well, let's just do nearest way. What he does. He didn't get enough donuts in there, I guess. Driver wages negative. Yes, donuts and pizza. I was fortunate to have grown up in a city with very, very good donuts. In fact, I always like telling the story. There was a, you know, Krispy Kreme that opened up, and then the local donut bakery actually caught fire. I don't know if it was arson or not or whatever, but so it was closed for, I don't know, 3 or 4 months. So of course everybody had to go to Krispy Kreme to get their donut fix. When it finally reopened, within about, I think it was like 6 to 8 months, the Krispy Kreme closed, went out of business because everybody stopped going there. It was brilliant. There you go. 98% it starts feeling red. I need to get the dolly version of this. Let's do 60,000 liters. Oops. Yeah, this guy's all sorts of messed up. I probably should mess with doing an auger unload into these trucks, but yeah. Let's do. I'm not sure, actually, Daryl. Oh, there we go. Oop. I got it. One second, and I will check. Let's do field 57 east. I don't think you do, no. And I'm not sure. So I did beet harvest add-on and didn't have any issues. I didn't put on maize plus. I think I have Strami as well, so I don't think there would be an issue if you ran a maize plus, but there's no native multi-fruit, just the standard. Yeah, I would think you could run Maze Plus and CCM and all that. Where is it? It's probably up here if you do so. Auger unload. Delete. Switch deactivate. There we go. Okay. That's the one I want. Not that one. There. Build 57 east. Great. just need to tie this back in. With this. This guy ever get back onto the crop? Hopefully his rows aren't screwed up. And then I want this guy to go to this one. See if I got it right. It didn't fill him up. Okay. Well, that's weird. Why he was just sitting there. My goodness, this is a big field. One hour. Just for this guy for basically half the field. 52 minutes for that guy. Yeah, that's a big field. We can fill up the trailer and make sure my auto drive worked on the unload. Really cool wheat texture on this field. Really nice looking. The straw swath is a bit interesting. Oops. Okay. Okay, I'll get out of your way. Where are you going? Okay. It's like spluttering out the straw. Although, I don't know, maybe that's realistic. Alright, we'll chase this guy up. And then I'll go dump. Let's see if that pulls the trailer. And then maybe if I can get these guys to running automation a bit better, I can go get some more harvesters and do the cornfields. Actually, I haven't even looked at the corn crop to see if it looks if it's a different texture. Almost a crash there. Yeah, we'll unload this. I'm thinking that the circle fields has a lot to do with the thinner pipe irrigation systems that circle the field, so they make the field exactly the length of the irrigation boom. My experience with ranch land is down in South Texas, and most of them seem to have those things for grass fields, and they're just I'm not really sure how it works, to be honest, but it looks like they're motorized in some fashion, and they just roll up and down the field, either spraying water or fertilizer or whatever. Yeah, Scott, yeah, that's kind of what I was guessing. That's how the irrigation system works, so they make it match. See if this fills him up. Nope. Oh, it did. And perfect. Let's ride along with this guy. Make sure I didn't make a huge hash of the route. Pardon me. So I think, yeah, 72, 36, and 68 are all corn. And look at those fields. I don't think Courseplay would like that. watch this guy dump his stuff, and then... grab some more harvesters. And we'll get on the corn a bit. And I'll go for... at least another 45 minutes or so. Okay, made it in. Yeah, that's kind of what I thought. Let's scoot that up. Okay, good. I thought he was going to make the loop. Perfect. And it should do both. Sweet. Realize what mod I forgot. Camera collision. And go. There you go. Yeah, there's a... I think it's... all the same family, I'm fairly certain. They basically are the family that keeps our church afloat. Huge pasture, I don't know. I actually don't know what the head count is, but it's probably a few hundred longhorn cattle. And they're beautiful. Their horns are massive. And then there's like a little island where like road, there's kind of like a junction of roads and there's an island in the middle and they've got several, grain bins, all their John Deere stuff, and then, farmland all around us. And I'm fairly certain I've seen the same tractors that are parked up there working out in the fields. And it's, uh-oh. He gets stuck. They just did a wheat harvest not too long ago. And then corn. What is he doing? Is he stuck? Oh. I know what it is. These dang header trailers are in the way. Again. The thing that always interests me the most. Definitely a lot of grassland around here for hay. In fact, they just baled hay recently, a month ago maybe. And I know you're supposed to like let the bales sit out and really dry and get the heat out so they don't catch on fire and all that stuff, but they're still sitting out there. And the guys that did the wheat field, they did wheat straw and baled that up into Heston bales. And then stacked them off to the side of the field, and then they're just sitting there. And some of the hay fields, there's still hay bales stacked off to the side, just all rotten from, I don't know, the last cut or maybe even last year's cut. And I'm thinking, why would you spend the time and the money and the operating, maintenance penalty on the equipment and fuel and all that to bale the grass and then, or, you know, hay, you know, ted it up, hay it up, and then just leave it? Because as far as I'm aware, hay has always been a premium here in Texas. I mean, farmers or ranchers, cattle ranchers are always wanting hay. Yeah, so down in South Texas, my mom's dad did cattle ranching for a long time. So we've got, he had three properties at one point. Now we just got the one, and he never farmed it. But in that area, it's primarily cotton. Most of what I see in Texas is cotton, wheat, and corn, of course, grass. Okay, I'm just gonna move this guy off to the side here. And I messed up earlier, so we're gonna do a little something here. 72, 36, and 6. Yeah, that guy that owns all that land, I'm certain it's his land. Honestly, I think he owns half the city around here in terms of the land that's not developed. And if it's the same guy, yeah, he goes to our church, and I'm gonna see if I can let me just at least park up and watch and. Maybe even let me drive a tractor chaser or something next harvest. It was cool. A couple months now ago when they were doing the wheat harvest, about 6 o'clock at night, 7 o'clock at night. You know, in Texas in June, July, it's 90 degrees at 8 o'clock at night. I was running errands. And I saw a couple chaser bins, a truck. I didn't see the harvesters yet, but it looked like they were setting up, getting ready to harvest. And then the next day, I drove the field and it was done. Oh, shoot, I forgot what it was. 72. I got busy chatting here. I'm gonna reset this back to the way it was because I messed up. Wheat stay off. Oh. That'll let me do it. Camel. 72, there you go. Weed state off. Okay. And then 72. Is it 7? Cool. Yeah, I guess it is a different texture. It's got the little tassels on it. I honestly don't remember what the base texture is now. Cool. So let's do the other ones real quick. 68 and 36. 36, sweet state. 36, corn, go. And 68. Let's get a couple harvesters. Let's do the X9s. It's fine. Four-wheel drive. GPS, yes. And then I believe I've got corn headers already. I'm just going to go ahead and reset them. Let's make sure. Did it actually go back to the shop? Okay, good. Do a little corn harvest, and then we will call it. I've got about 4 or 5 episodes of my Eureka series that I just sat down for like 3 nights and just cranked out a bunch of them, and I gotta edit them. And then I've got a little tutorial video that I'm trying to put together. Hopefully that will be, my goal is to have that out tomorrow. All right, we want to be able to, what do we want to do? We'll do 72. Off you go. I think for a map like this, it needs this treatment. Massive headers, massive capacities.
Whoa.
I swear I haven't been drinking. Oh, brilliant. Let's get him out of these telephone poles. Awesome. I'm assuming that's the same Dawson Creek from Gold Rush show. I think that's where one of them has an office or something. You know, I think actually West Texas has a bunch of vineyards. I know in the hill country, kind of the central area of Texas, it's very, very hilly hill country. There's a city there, like an old German city. Tons of wineries, but not many of them grow their own grapes. They do have grapes. And I think they grow enough to have an estate wine, so they can say that the grapes are from their estate, but most of them I've heard get their grapes from out West Texas area. Which is interesting because it's very dry and dusty and I wouldn't think conducive to growing grapes. Let's get this guy to 72 west. Oh no. 72. Oh, 72 west. Let's do unload combine on this guy. Oops. 57. East. And auger unload. I still didn't move it. 57. Blueberry. That would be an interesting thing to see. Blueberry harvest. Because blueberries grow in like bushes, right? So do you shake the bush? Do they have like a little thing that shakes the bush, or is it just yank the whole thing and then scrape out the limbs and stuff? Right, Where is that? Oh, it's here. Okay. Hey, look, that guy went off and... Oh, gosh. Jackknife. Started unloading, no problem. There's 72 West. Shakes him. Yeah, there was a friend of my dad's lived on a little plot of land that had, oh, I don't know, a good 50, 60 pecan trees. And he hired me a couple times to... So they had a machine that would come up, grab onto the branch, onto the trunk, and like vibrate like heck, and shake them all loose. And then they would have another guy come in with a little tractor with a rake on it. They would suck them all, pick them all up off the ground, but it couldn't get too close to the tree. So he would have me come in and pick up what they couldn't pick up, and bag it up, and then he'd go sell it and whatever. Whatever he sold it for, he'd give me a small cut. But it was pretty cool seeing him, like, reach up, grab the tree, and just shake it. Alright, I want 72 West. Corn. Where did my they both stuck down here. Yep. Much for that. Go home, you're drunk. Okay, we'll get there eventually. Yeah. I really wish they wouldn't do that. Just make them no collision or move them off the road a bit more. We'll get these guys to the field. I'll start on it. See how it goes for start on the. I'll manually drive the headlands. And then we will call it. But I should be on tomorrow. Although I am debating doing something much different for a stream tomorrow. If I can get some time during the day to try it out, see how it goes. I may try something a bit different. So there are trains. I copied a bunch of mods from that were running on the Yukon server that FSG has, and one of them is train stop mod, and it stops the train. You can go get in it and run it manually, but as soon as you, I think when you rejoin, it just stops it wherever it is. I don't know if it runs when nobody's on or not. Obviously, wouldn't be on to know, but yeah. I was driving around earlier and I saw it. I don't think you can tab the train. No. Yeah, that's very true. I probably will do that. Obviously, the guy who made it, super, super kudos to him for doing that. Must have taken a lot of work, but I don't think he drove combines. Down the road to see. Crop a little bit. I was about to say, I thought I was running Strami. I can't see where I'm going. No way, truck. Actually, I don't know if this will work, but... straight, especially with the keyboard. Oops. North. South. Looks good. What do you mean by macros? Oh, with my keyboard? I actually did not. I have not revisited that. I need to. I'm gonna have to do some Google and YouTubing on how to make it work with FS. So I definitely plan on putting it to good use with work. What is he doing? Why is he way over there? So weird. And of course this guy followed him. Yeah, that Chroma Studio is pretty slick. And then I've got the Viper mouse with the little charge dock that has lights on it, so you can control that too. And I'm planning on getting I'm drawing a blank now on the name of it. The big mouse pad with the RGB on the sides. Gargantuan or something like that. Seriously. I would expect that if I had just hit hire worker, but it's weird that course play is sending him way off. I'll just get him back in the field on the edge and leave it be. I need that extra performance too. What you're doing, friend, but the other guy doesn't seem to have any problems. Except for I keep saying he's slipping. See if that sheds any light on anything, although I doubt it. I wonder if it just doesn't like these headers. Yeah. crack at it. Really appreciate you guys hanging out with me tonight. I'm gonna do one more row down and then go ahead and call it for the night. Probably won't even make it. But maybe. Thanks, Scott. Appreciate that. Yeah. Glad to keep you guys entertained. A few little hiccups at the beginning, but got the automation going for the most part. Hopefully I provided at least some comedy of errors for you. I make it. Oh, I forgot. Oops. What am I doing? There we go. I wish those courseplay messages would get hidden when you hide the HUD. make it. I think we can. So yeah, now I just need to get some more guys on. Make it a proper multiplayer instead of me making a hash or trying to make it a multiplayer. Alrighty, that is going to be it for tonight. I do plan on getting on tomorrow. Like I said, thinking about doing something different, much, much different. So it'll be interesting to see how that goes. I'm going to try to mess with it during the day, and if it doesn't look like it's going to work, well then we'll either hop back on here or... The Yukon probably needs a visit. So that is all for me. Thank you guys. And we will see you next time.